Welcome to the first tutorial on Pure Desktop. Based on a small example, we will explain the basic functions to simplify the entry a little. If you start Pure Desktop for the first time, this background will be displayed first. This is an interactive tutorial to explain the basic functions as well. Currently the software is in wallpaper mode. To edit the individual elements, you have to switch to the designer mode. This is done via the tray icon in the taskbar. Either with the left mouse button or via the context menu, which is opened with the right mouse button. After switching to designer mode, you will probably have noticed that lines appeared on the wallpaper. These are grid lines. Elements adapt to the grid. This improves the positioning. Of course, this can also be deactivated. To open the main menu, you just have to press the right mouse button somewhere on the wallpaper. Now the project overview appears. Here are all your projects listed. You can create a new project or visit the Share Center to download community projects. We use the already open project. On the left side you will find the menu bar. Currently we are in the category projects. Then there are layers. It lists all the extensions used in the project, such as images, effects, visualizers, and so on. To add a new layer, go to the extensions category and select the appropriate extension there. This will create a new layer with this extension. If you want to download complete wallpapers or new extensions, this can be done via the category Share Center. The software itself can be adjusted via settings. There you can define performance settings, display settings and much more. General information about the software can be found under About. And now to the most important point, the supporters. Without these people, the project would not exist. Thanks a lot for this. Let's start now. Let's add a picture. For this we go into the category extensions. This category also has a sidebar. There, the extensions are divided into different categories. All extensions of the selected category are displayed on the right. The picture extension is in the multimedia category. There we choose the extension. It then opens directly the settings window. In addition, the tutorial wallpaper will be stopped if at least one layer is present. The image layer can now be found on the background. So that we also get something displayed, we now add an image to the layer. In order for the image to maintain the same aspect ratio, we need to change the mode from stretch to preserve aspect fit or preserve aspect crop. There are many different modes, but we'll use preserve aspect crop for this example. In order to scale the image to the full screen size, we have to switch the editing mode. To do this, we open the main window again with the right mouse button. In the lower bar you will find the different modes. The configuration mode, the transform mode, the depth mode and the rotation mode. To move an element and resize it, we need the transform mode. For scaling, we close all windows first. Now we move the mouse to the edge of the layer until the cursor adapts accordingly. Now we drag the layer to the required size. Next, let's add a clock. For this we open the main window again with the right mouse button, go to extensions and then into the category clocks. There we choose the extension modern. Now we place the clock in the position we need it for. After we have determined the position, we can change the settings. In this watch for example the colors of the hands. In order to run the time more fluently, the option smooth must be activated. However, this also requires more computer resources. Next we add a text element. This can be found under the category multimedia. There, as usual, click on it to create a layer with this extension. Now we adjust the size of the layer again. Next we change the parameters of the layer. In this example, this is the text, the font size and the color. Now I'll briefly explain the different modes. First, this would be the configuration mode. You can either open the setup window, duplicate the layer, or delete the layer. The next mode would be the order mode. In this mode you can determine which layer is at which depth. As a result, layers disappear behind other layers or appear above other layers. The last mode is the rotation mode. In this single plane can be rotated in all three axes. Finally, I show briefly how to disable the grid mode and reactivate it. This button deactivates or activates the grid. Whether the grid is activated or not can be seen on the grid lines. If these are visible, the grid is activated. If you change the size of a layer or move it while the grid mode is active, it adapts to the grid layout. If this is deactivated, the size and position can be determined freely. In order to complete the project, we assign a preview image and a name to the project. For this we go into the category Projects. Now we click on the name and can assign a new name to the project. To change the preview image, we need to right-click on the project and select Change Preview. Then we select a suitable picture. Preferably a screenshot of the finished project. Now you can use the project as you like or even share it with the community. How to do that? We explain in another how-to video. Have fun trying. Pure out.